Commissioner Wong.
My name is Zsuzsanna Rajkovic, I am associate professor of the Schlorat University in Budapest, in Hungary.
Do you accept this problem or would you like to reject it?
Timo Slovakia, I would like to reject this problem.
Thank you.
The team of Korea proposes the problem 22.
What number?
12.
Do you accept problem number 12?
We'll think it over very quickly.
Yes, please. Okay.
It's 1 minute.
Yes, we did something before, but now you have to.
Okay. Hello, I'm Jerry. I'm Peter Gloss, and I will present task number 12, the Kuhn Institute for Slovakia. Task. In a Kuhn Institute type of experiment, the standing waves produced can be made visible using applied powder. A closer look at the experiment reveals that the regions of powder have a substructure. Investigate its nature. Kuhn Institute. Kuhn Institute is a glass tube. Long glass tube, it has some diameter, best is around 4 centimeters. You have a piston on one end, and that you can move with it and change the length of the air column inside. There is some generator that produces sound with the same frequency, and you have inside a fine powder, for example, cord powder. And the basic idea is that the sound generator produces a sound. And the length of tube is L, and that should be multiplied, it should be some multiple of half of the length.
Thank you.
Queensland, and for our many overseas visitors, you to Australia. My name is Peter Lennox, and I'm the headmaster of Brisbane Drummer School. I'd like to extend a special welcome to my fellow head, Ms. Amanda Bell, principal of Brisbane Girls Grammar, and to our special guests this morning, Mr. Andrew Fraser, MP, who is representing the Queensland Minister for Education and the Arts, and Dr. Cheryl Hurst, who will shortly officially open the tournament. And also, a very warm welcome to Professor Gunnar Tibell, President of IYPT. Brisbane Grammar School and Brisbane Girls Grammar are providing the venues for the 2004 International Young Physicists Tournament. While I recognise that other members of the organising committee have also been greatly involved in the preparation of this event, I would like to take the opportunity to pay particular tribute to Dr. Alan Allenson and Mr. Philip O'Neill, two of our staff who are leading members of the organising committee for this year's event. I'm aware through direct knowledge of the work of these two men, just how much careful preparation and hard work has gone into the planning and organisation for the coming week on the part of all members of the organising committee. It's very appropriate that these two schools should be hosting this significant international tournament, for the two schools are among the oldest schools in Queensland, and both have been providing a first-rate, broad liberal education to boys and girls for over 125 years. Perhaps not so long a time for some of the schools that those of you from other countries may come from, but certainly a venerable time for schools in Australia. Both schools have very strong reputations for academic excellence and as educational leaders in our country. We trust that you will enjoy your stay in Brisbane and the facilities at our two schools, which will be available to you during your stay. And it's now my pleasure to introduce to you Mr. Andrew Fraser, member of the Queensland State Parliament, who is representing Ms. Anna Bligh, State Minister for Education and the Arts. We are very pleased that the Minister can be represented here this morning, as the Queensland Government has been a major sponsor of this tournament. Mr. Fraser is a member of the Australian Labor Party and was elected to State Parliament as the member for Mount Coober in February this year. Born in northern Queensland, Mr. Fraser had a distinguished school and university career, being among the 100 or so young Queensland Year 12 students to win a prestigious Australian Students' Prize in 1993 at the end of his secondary schooling. This was followed by a no less distinguished tertiary academic career at Griffith University in Commerce and Law that was capped by him being a university medalist. Mr. Fraser entered the world of politics at an early age, and as you will see, is still extremely youthful for a parliamentarian. He mixes his already successful career in politics with interests that include various sports, reading, cooking and travel. Mr. Fraser, we welcome you today at this very special gathering of young, enthusiastic and very talented science students and their mentors. I would invite you all to join me in extending a warm welcome to Mr. Fraser.
carpet snake. Now, the carpet snake is the title of our people on North Stradbroke Island, the other clan we are from, the Noongar people. You all may have known of our grandmother's sister, Ujuru Noongar. Ujuru, she spoke about the carpet snake. The carpet snake, like I said, is the title. It's a representation of our tribe, if you don't know what a totem is. And what it does is each family group and clan has a representation. It could be a tree or an animal, but this totem, we do not harm in any way. This is Kabul, the ancestor, the carpet snake.